Good morning, church.
Good morning, preach.
Good morning.
It's a joy to welcome all of you here on this Palm Sunday. Thank God for your presence and pray God's blessings upon all of you. Anybody celebrating birthdays this most holy week? No. Nicole said it. None of us are holy. Oh, your boys. Okay, all right. Your boys. That's, yeah, I have hearing problems. No. All right, well, we pray for them. You know, one is getting married soon. And Tate, we pray for you and ask God's blessings upon you. Anybody celebrating anniversaries this week? No. All right. It's a pretty quiet week. So there are no celebrations. And that simply is an indication that you can be here for Maundy Thursday, Good Friday, Easter Vigil, and Easter Sunday. So our services this week, we start at 7 on Thursday, the Maundy Thursday, and the watching with prayer. We spend a little time after the service in silence, watching the altar of repose, and remembering and recalling Jesus' moment in the Garden of Gethsemane. Could you not watch with me 1 hour? And the disciples, like all of us sometimes during prayer, fell asleep. And so we are imitating that and recalling the spiritual experience of that. And then Good Friday, the veneration of the cross. Easter Vigil, the celebration, which is when Easter actually began, the night before, because that's when the day started. And then on Easter Sunday, you have a choice, of course, between 9 and 11. Easter Vigil is at 7 p.m. on Saturday. Friday, 12 and 6. 12 and 6.
Okay. Now I'm going to talk about bingo.
Yes.
So you all are going to be here lots this week. So it's opportunity for you to drop off all of your bingo stuff. So if you signed up for baskets, we're still accepting sponsorships, ticket sales, all of those things. There's signups everywhere. If you have any questions, let me know. We're still looking for fillers, all of the things. So, and tell everyone you know, we need to sell tickets too. Most years we have sold out, but it's always like last minute. So we're down to the final weeks. So Mary Jo and I will be here over the next few weeks, and Julie too. Julie's here this week. So you can hit her up for bingo stuff this week too.
And there are flyers there. Yep. And so if you'd like to fill in.
Yeah, and the fillers, there is a QR code out in the parish hall, I believe, that you can, and if you need help finding it, just let me know. All that sign up is online.
Yes.
But if you have any questions about it, just let me know. I can sign you up. No problem.
Thank you very much. So keep that in mind. Yes.
With all these wonderful services we're having, and they are kind of wonderful, especially because this is the first time since COVID, I think, that we've run on Easter Vigil, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, so that's, to me at least, the most beautiful service we have the whole year. The only bad news part is that people aren't used to seeing that there are more parts for the parishioners to do at these special services than there are at our normal Sunday services. For example, on the Easter Vigil, there are 5 readings instead of 1 or 2 in there. So we need some extra readers. When you go to look at the sign-up sheet, it looks like, oh, there's somebody there. It's covered. It's not. We're running very short on readers for Saturday night, and oddly, on Good Friday, we're in good shape for the noon service, but at the 6 p.m. service, we're short on readers and people to do the Passion. So if you're going to be there on Friday night or Saturday night and would be willing to do some of those, we would really appreciate it. If you have any trouble signing up, contact me directly. I'll be glad to help.
Yes. And in case you got scared when Steve said we have a bunch of readings on Saturday night. Yes, we do have a lot of readings, but the service has changed, so we don't go through the whole service like we do today. The readings are in lieu of other aspects of the service, but it is a beautiful service, and you'll get to hear Jimmy's Alleluia chorus, all right? Yeah, come get that. All right, with that said, we also have next Sunday our Easter fun,
yes.
Right? Come with a lot of egg. Expectations.
Yes.
See what I did there?
Very excited.
Right, very excited. And fill them. Yes, it was an excellent time, right? But in order for us to have an excellent time, we do need some candies. My faithful parishioner put some on my door. But it's mine.
Oh.
So we need some for the kids.
Yes.
right?
My awesome teenage faithful servants are doing some stuffing today to get us prepared for next Sunday. So very thankful for that.
Yes, thank you all very much. All right. With that said, may you all have a holy week. And if any of you travel to be with family for Easter and won't be here, I'm going to wish you a soft but very hearty and cheerful Easter as well. Let us continue to walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself an offering and sacrifice to God.